We're going to use three different types of visual indicators. We'll use a hand every time I tap. Every time I hit a button on the outside of the device, we'll give you an icon. And we're going to use arrows to help point out key information on screen.
When you first launch VoiceOver, there are two ways of navigating through, in this example, the home screen. The first way I can navigate is I can tap, and what it will do is
97 new items, 16 apps.
You can see that it read that folder, and then it told me to double tap to open. If I can
activity tools folder, 14 apps. Double tap to open.
Okay. I swiped again on the screen. It moved to the next folder, which is productivity tools. It told me there were 14 apps, and it told me to double tap on the screen to open. So that's one way of navigating, and I can keep going from upper left-hand corner to lower right-hand corner by swiping one time to the right. A second way of using VoiceOver is if I have limited sight, I can swipe across an icon and it will tell me the contents of that icon, in the case of a folder, or the name of that icon, and it'll also give me a hint. I'm going to do that with paper camera first.
Adobe Viewer.
So I just swiped over across Adobe Viewer and it told me double tap to open. And then I'm now going to swipe across another folder and it'll tell me the contents of that folder.
Content Tools folder, 6 apps, double tap to open.
So I swiped over Content Tools folder. It told me there were 6 apps in there. And if I double tap, I can open it. Let's go ahead and double tap and let's open.
Opening Content Tools folder, Content Tools, opened.
One of the usage methodologies behind VoiceOver is to drag your finger across items. So I'm going to show you by dragging my fingers across and down and over across these app icons. And you'll see that VoiceOver starts reading them back to me. So watch.
AB, Cutaba, Injini, Drums, Finger Drums, Fun Box, Food, My First FW, Finger Drums, Guitar Free, I Hear You, Toka Hair Salon, Hey, Doll.
So the way that I did that was drag my finger across whatever I wanted it to read back to me. Now I want to use VoiceOver to help me navigate from page to page. So as you can see on screen, I'm on the last icon of the page, and if I tap or flick over, if I tap or flick on the page icons at the bottom, I can actually now go to the page scroller. So I'm going to do that. And it's now, the VoiceOver is giving me feedback about what page it is. If I double tap again, I can go to page 2.
Page 2 of 9, adjustable.
And if I double tap again, I can go to page 3.
Page 3 of 9, adjustable.
Now, if I swipe across an icon, I can, or an app, I can then activate that app.
Injini.
And if I double tap, it'll open and launch the icon. If I want to get back home, then I press the home button once, and I'm back on the home screen. So that's how you go backwards. You can cycle all the way through, but oftentimes it's just easier just to go back to the home screen. VoiceOver is a very powerful feature. And in order to change the settings of how VoiceOver behaves without having to go back to the settings application, iOS environment has implemented this rotor concept. So I have VoiceOver activated, and what I can do basically, if you remember in the earlier part of the video, we have when you flick to the right or to the left, you can navigate left or right. But then if you flick up or down, depending on how you have the rotor setting, you can get different characteristics from VoiceOver. So right now, so let's focus on activating the rotor first, changing the setting, and then showing you the setting. So the way that you activate the rotor is it's like turning a dial. It's a two-finger action. You put both fingers down on the iPad surface, and you turn it as if you were turning a dial.
Words.
And that's exactly what I did. I changed now to words. I'm going to change it again. I'm going to turn my little dial.
Containers.
Now it'll go to containers, headings, and vertical. Now I'm at vertical navigation. So if I were to flick down, instead of going and instead of it reading the word of the container back to me, it's actually going to go down to
social folder.
And if I go down again, it'll go down to development. If I go up, it will go up. And that's because I have vertical navigation set up. Now I'm going to change this one more time to characters, and I'm going to go up and down. I'm going to flick up and down, and you'll hear it read my name letter by letter. The name of the folder.
Semi-folder, A, M.
So That's where you can change the character or have read the word or vertical scroll, and you can all do this on the fly while VoiceOver is activated.
For more information, go to iPadsForSpecialNeedsBook.com, where you'll find more videos, other resources like cheat sheets, and a book on how to use the iPad for your special needs user.